Hello students, yesterday we have just finished the chapter of waves, and there we have discussed a number of topics. You have learned a number of topics, and obviously if a lot of topics, lot of applications we have, then definitely there can be lot of conceptual questions that in your mind. And also from our daily life, as we are seeing, waves are generated in waves are like you are seeing ocean wave, you are seeing winds, and you are seeing sound wave. Means a lot of waves you are just seeing. Then in that case, obviously there are a lot of questions that comes in your mind. So that's why first of all, in the on this chapter waves, let's discuss the conceptual problem that can be asked for examination, and that can trigger your mind, because there are different types of conceptual problems that can be asked. Like one question I have just discussed to you yesterday, that is the means you, if you want to detect the damage in the bridges, then it is best option to listen them. So this is the sentence and you have to justify that. Then sometimes you will think, how can we listen the non-living things? But still, the acoustical wave, acoustical sensor provide us to listen that also, because whenever we are listening something, it means that we are capturing some frequency there. And also after cracking of the bridges and other parts, then there is the high frequency sound that is produced. So if we capture that frequency, then you can detect easily where the bridges damaged. So in the same way, here as number of topics we have just discussed, then let's see the conceptual problem one by one on this chapter. So first, in this chapter, first thing that we have studied, that is wave motion. So first of all, we have seen that what is wave, how many types of waves we have, and what is the wave motion, wave functions, and harmonic wave function, means the characteristics of wave and equation of wave where we have debated. Let's see the conceptual problems related to it first of all. So one by one I will just speak the questions here. I'm not going to write it here. So let's just listen it, and after that I will discuss its answer also. So the first question is that why are longitudinal waves called pressure wave? So as we know that waves are of two types. First is transverse wave, second is longitudinal waves. So if in the case of longitudinal waves, we can also call this wave as the pressure wave. Why we have to call it as the pressure wave? So the answer is in its definition. As we know that in the case of longitudinal wave, the particles are oscillating in the same direction to the direction of propagation, and also they are oscillating in forms of compressions and refractions. So in case of compressions, you know that particles come closer to each other. In case of refraction, they are going far away from each other. So in this way, you are seeing that the density of the particles that are increasing, in this way volume is increasing, and also there is a pressure that is creating in this region due to high density, due to the closure of the particles here. Because if particle or molecule, whatever that are oscillating, then if they will come closer, then definitely they will impart some momentum, and it means that there will be some pressure creation due to that. So that's why in every compression and refraction, there is pressure difference that is created continuously during the propagation of longitudinal wave. So that's why due to pressure change, due to pressure creation, you can call it also pressure waves. The second question is that transverse waves are not produced in liquids and gaseous systems. Why? You know that transverse waves, we can produce transverse wave only in solids, not in liquid, not gases. What is the reason behind that? So as we know that transverse waves that are what, that in which particles or molecules that are oscillating perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So in that case, if they are oscillating perpendicular, then for the perpendicular motion, obviously a periodic array we are needed there. And also in this way, there is change in shape occurs due to the transverse wave motion, or also you know that transverse wave motion that are propagating in the medium in forms of crest and throw. So in every crest and throw we can see that there is change in shape occur. So if change in shape is producing here, then there should be the property of elasticity, so that it can bring the deformed shape to its initial shape. Because you know that already we have discussed that what are the condition for the mechanical wave production we are needed. So first condition is that medium should have the property of elasticity. Secondly, it should have the property of inertia. So these are the, and there should be low friction. So these are the primary proper conditions that are needed. We have already discussed why we are needing that. Because if there should not be any elasticity, then definitely due to lack of elasticity, if particle will leave its position and it will be deformed, then after that it will not return to its position, then there should there will not be any kind of oscillation. So if there will not be oscillation, there cannot be production of wave through it. So medium should have also the property of elasticity. Secondly thing, it should have the property of inertia, because if it will not have the property of inertia, then it cannot restore its energy, and whenever there is oscillation, in that case energy redistribution is taking place, and particle have to restore its energy so that it can come to its our original position. So there, for that, inertia property is must in the system also. And if there will be greater friction, then definitely you know that if resisting forces will be greater, it means that deforming force is greater, than oscillations will be seized there. So that's why low friction, this should be, these are the conditions that are necessary for the wave production. So for means here for the transverse wave system, as we have talked here, the change in shapes occurs due to transverse wave motion. So if change in shape is producing, then definitely medium should have the elasticity of shape. It means that modulus of rigidity it should have, and we know that modulus of rigidity, that is only possessing by the solids, only possessing by the rigid materials. So that's why liquid and gaseous systems, as they are not possessing any kinds of modulus of rigidity, that's why transverse waves cannot be generated in that, as they cannot bring their shapes to their, deformed shapes to their original shapes. So this is the reason behind it. Third question is that is superposition principle is applicable to electromagnetic waves also or not? So yes, superposition principles are applicable to any kinds of waves that are propagating in the medium if they have same frequency or whatever. Actually, superposition principle is applicable to all types of wave. If they are just propagating in the space and if they are interfering with each other, then after their interference, if you want to calculate the resulting displacement of the wave, then that can be always defined or determined by the superposition principle. The application of superposition principle we are studying in case of electromagnetic wave, as the interference of light, diffraction of light, they are all the examples of the superpositions of principle. So yes, superposition principle we are getting in electromagnetic waves also. Next question is that as we are seeing that ocean waves that are hitting to a hitting a beach is always found to be normal to the shore. So if you are just standing on beach and you are seeing that the ocean waves that are coming towards you and that are hitting to the beach, and the if you will see the source, and at the source it is just perpendicular in the normal direction. Suppose that this is the back of the shore of the beach, then if ocean waves are coming, then ocean waves always hits it in the normal direction. So what is the reason behind that, why they are only hitting it the normal direction? So the reason is that the ocean waves that are transverse in nature. So if transverse wave is producing anywhere, it means that the particles are oscillating perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So this is the, suppose that this is the since, and in the ocean cases, as they are the waves that are generating in the circular forms, and hence if you can see it, this also, suppose you are taking a stone and throw it into the pond. Then in that case, you will you can see that the waves that are generated there, that are just like the circular waves that are generating. So in that way, oceans are also in the oceans, there are the waves that are generating that are circular in nature. But if you will see the propagation of wave, transverse wave in the oceans, as there are large area and if they are propagating, then their radii is continuously increasing. And due to large area, if you will see the any arc of the radii, that sphere, obviously this is circular, and if you will see any arc, then due to large area it appears as the plane wave. So that's why a plane wave is just hitting to the, as they are propagating like this, just a perpendicular direction, then if they are hitting to the shore, then it is appears as the normal wave. So this is the reason, that's why we are just feeling that ocean waves are hitting in the perpendicular direction to the shore. Next question is that what is the periodic wave function? How can you define it? So as we have already defined, is the wave that is called periodic if the displacement or of the wave that is just repeating its path after a certain interval of time or after a certain distance. Like we have seen that after every time period, after every completion of one time period, the waves always starts to oscillate in the same manner that it was before that one time period. So it means that displacement of the waves that are repeating after some every interval of time or every interval of distance, like after one wavelength, if you will see the wave that is in the same manner like this, if this is wave that is propagating in the medium, then you can see that here the wave started from here and here one oscillation is completed. So if you will see the time here, then this is called the time taken to complete one oscillation, that is time period. So after one time period, again we are seeing that the particle is started to execute the same time kinds of motion. So it is repeating its path after t time period. And again, if you will see the distance traveled by it, then this distance traveled by it in the one oscillation, that is called its wavelength. So after every wavelength, if you can see that after this every this lambda distance, particles again starts to oscillate in the same manner. So it is repeating its path after certain interval of time or after certain interval of distance. So such types of waves, if this condition is fulfilling anywhere, then that wave is known as periodic wave. So I think there is no confusion in that section. Next question, that is why is the harmonic what is the harmonic wave function exactly? So as we know that here we have studied all the waves in the terms of harmonic wave function. So first of all, you have to understand what is harmonic wave function. As we have discussed already, if the wave function that is representing in terms of sine or cosine function, then in that way you can say that the wave function that is harmonic in nature. Next question is that if suppose that we have some wave functions, then we have to predict that whether the that wave functions, they are representing wave motion or not. So let's see them. I will write that on the board. That these types of wave functions that we have, then whether these wave functions are representing any kinds of wave motion or not. So as you can see that these are the formula for this. And while dealing with the wave motion, as we have taken that to the function that will represent the wave motion, if it is single value, first thing, it is continuous, it is harmonic, and also it is finite at every point. So as we are seeing that, first of all, these all waves are not harmonic in nature. So secondly, other factors is the possible, but still these are not harmonic and continuous in nature. That's why you can see that here these are not producing the wave motion, any kinds of wave motion. So these functions are not showing the wave motion, but still they are showing some kinds of motion, but not, that is not the wave motion. So for the wave motion, some of the conditions are always necessary. Also, we have discussed while we were just discussing the concept of harmonic wave function and periodic wave function. So for the discussion, if any function have to represent the wave motion, that should be harmonic, that should be single valued, that should be finite or continuous, clear? I think there is no problem in that. So the conceptual problems related to wave motions, that is, we have discussed, I think, a number of concepts we have discussed. There is now no confusion at all in the topics, and in the discussion of this wave motion, I have just discussed some of the topics also, so that you can just remind them in your mind. So let's see some conceptual problems that are related to sound wave. So the next topic, as you have studied the sound wave. So one by one, for every topic, let's see the conceptual problems. As here, a number of conceptual problems you have. So the first conceptual problem for the sound wave is you are very familiar with it. That is, the thunder of lightning is heard after some moments as the flash you are seeing. So if you will see the flash of thundering, then thunder of lightning, then in that case you are seeing that first the flash, after some times you are hearing the sound of the thunder of lightning. What is the reason? This is very clear reason. As you know that if somewhere, suppose that here the thunder of lightning that is producing, and here you are, then the distance between you and this point, this is this, then obviously the distance traveled to reach you, that is same for the light waves and that is same for the sound waves. Both are same. So these have to travel same distance. And also you know that these have the different velocities. So if these have the different velocities, means sound waves in air that have 332 meter per second only, but light waves that are traveling with 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So this is a huge difference in that, and if you will calculate time taken by it to reach to you, then this time is distance upon velocity. So now you can solve it easily and you can see that what is the time taken by the wave to reach to you, then definitely if greater will be the velocity, less time it will the wave will take to reach to you, because velocity is in the numerator. Then it means that light will or flash of light that will reach to you first, because it is taking less time in comparison to the sound wave. So this is the reason behind that you are just listening sound after the light. Next question is that can two astronauts talk on the surface of the moon as they are doing on the earth? As we are talking on the earth easily, then can we talk on the moon surface or not? And if you can or you cannot, then what is the reason behind it? So as you know that on the moon surface there is no atmosphere. The reason it also the absence of atmosphere, also you know that because the escape velocity of the air molecules that are greater than the orbital velocity of the air. So because air molecules have greater velocity to escape from the moon surface easily, that's why means the velocity of air molecules is greater than the escape velocity at the moon surface. So that's why there is no existence of atmosphere on the moon surface. All the gas molecules that can escape from its surface or gravity easily. So if there is no atmosphere, then you know that the sound needs to propagate through the medium, because if there is no medium, then there cannot be the production of mechanical waves. So the condition for the production of mechanical wave is that we always need a medium, because if we are producing, suppose that here we are producing sound, then if you are listening to me, it means that there is the presence of air particles between us, and these air molecules get disturbed after getting the energy, sound energy from me, and after that they started to oscillate, and due to their oscillation, energy transfer is taking place continuously through the molecules and it is reaching to you. So this is the reason here the air molecules present on the earth that allow us to talk to each other. So this is very special things that we have got here, so that we can hear to we can talk, we can hear to others and other things like that. So this kind of things we cannot perform on the moon surface. There is no atmosphere, sound waves cannot propagate in the mediums on the moon surface. So that's why there is no production of sound, no astronauts can talk there on the moon surface. So I think that reason is clear to you. Still, if anywhere there is no medium to for the propagation of sound, then there cannot be any types of talk in that section. But still, one very actually interesting application of sound energy we have, that is if you can modulate sound energy on any high frequency wave, like modulation process we are using to send or to transmit our waves in the space, also to search or to know about the aliens, then in that case we are using sound energy, because here we don't know still that in which form sound energy is created or converted. This is very actually interesting application of sound energy also, and interesting puzzle for us, that where you can use the sound energy. As we I am just producing sound, and due to sound productions you are just listening or not listening, whatever. So as you know that energy conservation is taking place at every places, it means that it is the universal law of conservation we have. So if the energy of universe that is constant, energy can only just converted into another forms, it cannot created or destroyed. So it means that if you are producing any kinds of energy, sound energy if you are producing, then this kind of energy also it should have to convert in either another form, or it should be used at somewhere. So in that way you are not and we are not aware of any kinds of use of this types of sound energy. So this is the reason by which we are just thinking that this sound energy is some kinds of preserved energy. This is just restored or preserved in the our system or in the space. So for the just detection of the aliens and other planets, like we can use the sound energy, as it is not dissipating and it is not transferring to anyone, it is preserved energy. Then if you will modulate this energy on any high carrier wave, high frequency wave, like electromagnetic wave, we can use for as a carrier this wave. So we are using this wave to transmit to another planets and in our space, so that if there anywhere there is the presence of aliens, then they can detect, receive that signal, they can just detect or demodulate the signal. After demodulation, they will get whole of the sound energy that we have sent to them. And after that, if you will if they will have the technology, then they can detect it. If they will not have any technology, then they will not detect it. But still, if obviously if they will have technology, they can detect it. After detecting, we can be able to know if somewhere there is any presence of aliens in our space. So this is the, in this way sound energy is also helped us in so many ways. This is very interesting thing actually, we have just seen and we are using in our life. Next thing is that for the sound wave, that is what are the essential points of difference between sound waves and electromagnetic wave. So as two types of waves we have, actually we have three types of waves: matter waves, electromagnetic waves, sound waves. So what is the difference in sound waves and first of all electromagnetic waves or light waves? You know that light is electromagnetic wave. We have seven types of electromagnetic waves, in which visual light is one part of it also. So first now let's see only the difference between light and sound. As we are seeing the thunder of lightning, in that case we are seeing both of the waves. Then what is the essential difference between them? First difference is that sound needs to travel through a medium. It is, means it is always needing medium to travel or to propagate, means these are the mechanical waves completely. But the electromagnetic waves or light waves are electromagnetic in nature. And we know that electromagnetic waves doesn't need any kinds of medium for its propagation. So they can radiate in the medium or in the free space, in the vacuum, everywhere, means they don't need any kinds of medium for its propagation. So first difference, which is, that is very important difference. Sound waves are mechanical waves, light waves are electromagnetic waves. Only while I speak this, the difference is very clear, because electromagnetic waves, there is no need to of the medium, but for the mechanical wave, for their propagation, we always need a medium. If there is no medium, it cannot be propagated. Secondly thing is that if you will see the velocity of sound wave and velocity of light, so there is a huge difference between them also. Velocity of light, that is in vacuum, its value is 3 to 10 power 8 meter per second. And also if it is traveling in the medium, then there is change in velocity that occurs, but still the velocity cannot be equal to the velocity of sound. That is very less than the velocity of light. The velocity of sound is in air only, that is 32 meter per second. So this is the huge difference that is essentially between sound and light energy. So I think that is clear to you. So in next case is that if actually situational problem we have, that is if you are filling a bucket with water, then you are just you feel that the pitch of sounds that is changing. What is the reason behind it? Sometimes if you just take the empty bucket and after that started to fill water into it, then you will feel that pitch of the sound that is just changing every time when you are filling it. What is the reason behind it? So as if you will see the bucket, then you can take it just like the open pipe or a closed actually pipe, you can see it. So as we have discussed the problem of closed organ pipe, in that case we have seen that one end that is such types of things. This is the concept of closed organ pipes. We have one end is just closed and another end is open. So bucket is just like this, and if you will start to fill up water into it, then definitely sound is producing here, and the reflection of wave that will take place here means a formation of a standing or stationary wave that in the bucket that will take place here. So if a standing wave or stationary waves that are producing here due to the production of sound, then definitely you can see the frequency of this wave, and frequency we have seen that this is bit by here 4L. So if there is any change, any kind of change in L, it means that first of all water is just, we have filled water to this height, then definitely L is only this. If this L is changing, means we are only filling the bucket here continuously, this is bucket our, and now L is started to increase, then while increasing L, there is decrease in frequency occurs. So if frequency is continuously decreasing, it means that the pitch of sounds that you will listen, that will change also. Actually pitch that is related to the change in that is related to frequency, loudness that is related to intensity. So some of the things that are arises while we are discussing sound waves, and you don't have to confuse here. If somewhere you are talking about the pitch, it means that you are talking about the frequency, and if you are talking about the loudness, you are talking about the intensity there. So due to change in frequency, there is change in pitch occurs while we are filling the any empty bucket. From that we have discussed, that is we have just discussed a number of applications of the superposition principle. There we have discussed standing wave or stationary wave. After that we have discussed beats phenomena. After that Doppler effect. So let's see the conceptual problems based on that. So first of all, conceptual problems, one conceptual problems I will discuss here. Rest of the conceptual problems we will discuss in next class. So first is on the basis of standing wave. So as you can see that, if you will see musical instrument, if you are seeing that, in every musical instrument there is a protrusion of the hollow box. In every stringed, if you will see stringed musical instrument like guitar, sitar, and other things, then you are seeing that a hollow box that is providing with it. What is the reason there? Can't we produce? Suppose that this is our musical instrument and a string is attached to it. So can't we produce sound here with this thing? If you are not providing any kinds of hollow box here. So the reason is that the hollow box that we are providing to increase the surface area, and if we will increase surface area, then you know that the intensity is directly proportional to the surface area. So to increase the intensity, we are just doing this we are providing the hollow box there only for that reason. So this is the reason that we are providing hollow box in every musical instrument that are stringed. If you are seeing, actually that string length and other factors that changes frequency of the vibration, means that is changing pitch of the vibration. But if you know and if you want to change the loudness, then you have to change its surface area. So if surface area will change, intensity will change according to that, loudness will change. So pitch and loudness, both of the things we are needed while we are producing any music. So that's why we are providing both of the kinds of things according to our need. So later the rest of the things we will discuss in next class. While actually the number of questions here from the your musical industry, musical instruments. So let's discuss, already we have discussed a number of things, but still the conceptual problems that can be asked here and that can trigger your mind. So let's discuss in your next classes. So let's end it here guys today. Thank you.